NY News Tonight is a community service of the New York Institute of Technology.
Many Long Islanders depend on the Long Island Railroad to get to work. But making sure the trains run on time is a big job. We'll show you who does that job and all the things that can go wrong.
LI News Tonight with the award-winning LI News Team.
Good evening, I'm Trish Bergen, sitting in for Ken Eckhart with this special edition of LI News Tonight. You may be one of the more than 250,000 Long Islanders who rely on the Long Island Railroad to get to and from work every weekday. If not, chances are you know someone who is. But what you probably don't know is what goes on behind the scenes of the railroad in an effort to keep all the trains running on the right track. The LIRR dispatches over 700 trains each weekday, and this intense volume of train traffic sometimes leaves room for error. Well, tonight we'll take you into the Long Island Railroad's dispatching centers, meet some of the workers who help keep all the trains running on time, and we'll find out what happens when things do go wrong. It's another early morning for Long Island Railroad commuters. That means waiting for the train that will start another day at work. It's the time of day you don't want anything to go wrong. You want the trains there on time, and you want to get to where you're going on schedule. A 250,000 Long Island commuters depend on the trains to run smoothly. But the trains don't just do that on their own. A smooth-running train system is the end product of lots of work by lots of people.
It's somewhat something that I wish almost the whole public could see. There's so much more that goes beyond behind the scenes that the public doesn't see. And you really, to grasp it, you'd have to see it.
Well, then let's take a look.
That's a roger. We'll get police. Thank you. 204.
This room is often referred to as the heartbeat of the Long Island Railroad. Its real name is the Movement Bureau. The Movement Bureau is one of two main headquarters that work to keep the trains operating on schedule. It's located upstairs at the Jamaica train station, and it's from this room that most of the movement of the LIRR is monitored and controlled.
If the railroad functions like a wheel, I'd like to think of the Movement Bureau as the hub of the railroad. All train movement aspects outside of Penn Station, from Long Island City to Montauk, are monitored and controlled from this office.
There are several jobs within the Movement Bureau that are critical in coordinating train movement. Railroad officials say among the most important jobs is the one shared by the train dispatchers. During rush hour, there are up to 5 train dispatchers at work in the Movement Bureau, and it's up to them to decide which trains will run on which track. And they make these decisions while carefully studying a computer designed to monitor the on-time performance of the trains each day.
The Timex system is a computerized system. It's called the Train Information Monitoring and Control System. What that does, it allows us to monitor where any train is at a given moment.
Because the train dispatcher sits inside a cubicle, unable to visually monitor the trains, this computer system becomes the critical eyes and ears of the train dispatcher. If the computer indicates that a train is delayed, the dispatchers may decide to direct the next train on a different track. Now, you might think that the train dispatcher simply calls the engineer and tells him what track to use, but that's not at all how it works. In fact, the engineer has absolutely no steering control over what track the train uses. Instead, that's all left up to the tower controller. The train dispatcher calls a tower controller who mans a tower like this one. There are 15 towers spread out along the railways, and depending upon the location of the train is what determines which tower the train dispatcher will call.
904 is in at 9:15 when they issued paperwork for 9:11.
Kenny, you want to go to the West Lab first, or you want to go to 4 Station for 2 Yard E?
The train dispatcher tells the tower controller what track to direct the train onto next, and by flipping these switches, the tower controller actually shifts the track, which steers the train.
The towers are the ones that physically route the customer's trains to the destination. Each train dispatcher is in charge of those towers.
May I have your attention, please? Your attention, please. The westbound train to New York, scheduled to depart Ronkonkoma at 9:06. is currently being delayed at Ronkonkoma Station.
The public announcement operator is also part of the Movement Bureau, and he also relies on the computer system. When a delay is reported on the computer, it's his voice you hear on the loudspeaker, informing almost every Long Island train station of any delays or cancellations. These announcements are designed to relieve passenger frustrations when delays occur.
Do you think when there's a change in train scheduling that they keep you informed?
Sometimes I think they've gotten a lot better with the train schedule. The on-time delays aren't as much, and I think they've gotten a lot better.
I think there are quite a few delays that we don't know about.
It's getting better. Used to be terrible. Lately, they're doing a better job at it.
Now that we've seen what happens to the Long Island Railroad trains while they're still on Long Island, when we come back, we'll take a look at the second operations bureau that takes over the duty of monitoring the trains as they get closer to Penn Station. Right after this, as LI News Tonight continues.
The stiletto, outlawed in most major cities. The trench knife, it boasts a 7-inch solid steel blade. The survival knife, designed to cut through virtually anything. Yet the most dangerous knife of all may be the one we use to eat too much high-fat food, the ordinary table knife. For a free booklet on how to help reduce your risk of cancer and heart disease through low-fat eating, call 1-800-EAT-LEAN.
I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed days, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
If you're not recycling, you're throwing it all away.
As Long Island Railroad trains enter the tunnels into Penn Station, the second operation bureau takes over. It's called the Station Master's Office, and it's located here in Penn Station.
Well, what typically happens is when a train is coming into Penn Station, when he enters the tunnel that has access to the station, he'll contact us via radio and to determine the disposition of his train. What we'll do is we'll tell him what track his train will be arriving on.
Although the station master's office at Penn Station is almost 11 miles from the Movement Bureau in Jamaica, the two are closely linked in their efforts to coordinate train movement into and out of Penn Station.
There's a very close link between Penn Station and us to, again, keep everything flowing smoothly. If they cannot handle the volume of trains that we send them, we have to make alternate arrangements. We're the ones that have to decide to shut off, I'll say, curtail service into New York, reroute trains, whatever the case is.
Long Island trains arrive and depart on tracks 13 through 21 at Penn Station, and the station master's office is responsible for closely monitoring those particular tracks, several of which are also used by Amtrak.
What we do is we coordinate activities with Amtrak as far as track utilization and tunnel spacing of these trains that we share with them.
Railroad officials and commuters say the morning rush hour is the most hectic time of the day. Every morning between 6 and 10, trains arrive on tracks 13 through 21 about every 3 minutes.
Tell me what rush hour is like compared to the rest of the day.
It's pretty hectic. After 10 o'clock, it calms down quite a bit. Right now, with the 90 trains that that arrive in Penn Station between 6 and 10, it's a pretty busy operation.
Tell me what rush hour is like in Penn Station.
Very hectic. Some nights nerve-wracking.
It's a lot of people. You know, if you're not used to it, I guess it would drive you a little crazy.
Workers in the station master's office rely on these TV screens to monitor train arrivals and departures.
The monitors on the wall that you see show the tracks at platform level from tracks 13 through tracks 21, which is the tracks that the Long Island Railroad uses.
And like the Movement Bureau, the station master's office also uses the computer system to determine which trains are on time and which are late. The lead transportation manager and the assistant transportation manager work together in coordinating the activity of the trains through the tunnels. And the station master's office also has a public announcement operator who makes the departure announcements to the commuters in Penn Station.
7:39 Ronkonkoma train. Change at Ronkonkoma for Greenport. changing Hicksville for Port Jefferson.
He's also responsible for posting departures, which appear on those screens you see scattered about the waiting area.
But things don't always run smoothly for the Long Island Railroad. When we come back, we'll find out what happens in an emergency situation and how train service is affected. Stay with us.
Mom, I'm tired. Can we go home now?
2 months ago, the only job this woman could take was one where she could take her son with her. What do you do when there's no one to watch him but you? She's getting help at a daycare center. They got help from the United Way. All because the United Way got help from you. The United Way. It brings out the best in all of us.
There was a time when people helped their neighbors, and together they built a stronger community. This spirit lives on today in NeighborWorks, a unique partnership of local residents, business, and government leaders. NeighborWorks volunteers have rebuilt over 100,000 homes, restoring pride to millions of neighbors. So help a neighbor and a nation. Join NeighborWorks. Reversing decline, rebuilding pride.
When an emergency situation occurs, the Jamaica Bureau and the Penn Station office try to keep trains flowing while also tending to the emergency. This is when it's most critical that both main headquarters work together smoothly.
If a train unfortunately strikes an automobile, the tower will immediately transfer that information to the train dispatcher. The train dispatcher will immediately contact the chief. The chief has hotlines to the fire departments, police departments, any outside agency.
And while the chief dispatcher is notifying emergency units and the Jamaica station, the dispatchers will immediately begin to reroute trains around the affected area. The public announcement operator gets on the loudspeaker and begins notifying passengers waiting at stations of any service changes. And according to the chief dispatcher at the Movement Bureau, it can all get pretty stressful.
Because you're constantly answering phones, making split-second decisions. Depending on the nature of the problem, you know through experience that thousands, literally thousands of people can be delayed, and that you are responsible.
It's all taking place with a great deal of coordination, unseen, of course, to the public, but very effective and very professionally done.
Long Island Railroad commuters grade the railroad's performance once a year through the LIRR Commuter Council Annual Report Card. The most recent report card gave the railroad a B for its on-time performance. That's said to be the best grade ever in that category since the report card program started 7 years ago. But commuters made it clear to the railroad that there's still room for improvement in other areas. They gave the railroad a C in cleanliness, a D for its restrooms, and a C for those announcements you hear or don't hear. Now railroad officials say with the railroad's on-time performance showing improvement, they'll focus more attention on other areas that commuters still seem to be unhappy with. That's all for this special edition of LI News Tonight. I'm Trish Bergen, sitting in for Ken Eckhart. We'll see you again next time. Have a good night.